Hello, this is Teacher Yakubu as usual. How are you, peoples? Today we are beginning a very big topic. However, we shall finish it, okay? That is growing crops. We have started a very long topic, but we shall finish all the work, okay? Most of the things here is revision, and you did most of this work in the P3. First of all, let us define a crop. A crop is a plant grown for a purpose. Any plant grown for a purpose. It can be for fruits, it can be for shade, anything, okay? Now, those crops are in these five types. The first type of crops, we have the cereal crops. We have the legumes. Oh, you remember I told you they are also called leguminous crops. But sometimes we say legumes. We have the root crops. We also have the fruit crops and the vegetable crops. We shall be looking at one by one. Let us begin with these cereals. Cereals are sometimes called grain crops or monopods. Why do we call them grain crops? Like we shall be listing examples of maize, sorghum, and very many are there. Why do we call them grain crops? They produce grains, those seeds of maize, of rice. We call them grains. That's why they are called grain crops. Why do we call them monopods? They will ask you in the exam, write down any two examples of monopods. Don't write seeds, write the plants, like a maize plant, like wheat plant. Those are the monopods. Why do we call them monopods? They produce monocotyledonous seeds, okay? They produce monocotyledonous seeds. These are the examples I have been talking about of the cereals or the cereal crops. One, rice is here, millet, maize, sorghum, wheat, barley, oats. All these are cereal crops, okay? Number two of the types of crops, let us look at leguminous crops. I told you they are also called legumes, don't get lost. These leguminous crops we defined in P3 and we say leguminous crops are crops which have nodules. They have nodules on their roots and they have their seeds in the pods. Okay? Leguminous crops are crops that have nodules on their roots and have their seeds in the pods. Examples of those legumes include groundnuts, beans, soya beans, and peas. Now, the nodules I'm talking about, the structure of their roots is here. This is the root system of the leguminous crops. They have those small balls. Sometimes they will ask you, what do we call the small balls found on the root system of the leguminous crops? They are called root nodules. These small balls, remember I told you, they have something inside they store, that is nitrogen-fixing bacteria. That bacteria, those bacteria, they fix nitrates in the soil. Okay? Nitrates. I said nitrates. Don't say any other word. That is the importance of these nodules. I told you, they also have their seeds in pods. This is the structure of the pod. You can see this. For example, this one is of the beans. Also here. The seeds are inside the pod. Okay? This one is the pod and those are the seeds. Okay? Then from there, as usual, I always have a very simple activity. Now this one is of five numbers, which I want you to write in your books, neatly like we always do in class, and then you answer correctly. What you don't know, try to consult, okay? You consult and have everything marked correctly. I'm going to mark this one. Thank you. Bye. We meet.